Okay, so today we'll be looking into how to increase your productivity using an app. Okay, the app is called as TickTick. Okay, just click here, T-I-C-K, T-I-C-K, right? So this is the app, okay? So once you come here, install the app, and it will also give you an automatic reminders and how you can utilize that. Okay, so now I think so let's go to open the app. Okay, so it's installed, we just opened. Okay, so this is the welcome screen. We'll be skipping this as of now. Skip tutorial 1, 2, 3. Okay, so now I skipped all the tutorials. As of now, we are in the inbox. Okay, so in inbox is the one. So as of now, we finished the step one, we installed the software. Okay, the step two would be creating a new account. So let's not go there, let's go to the settings and we'll create a new account by signing in with our Gmail account. Okay, so we'll be signing in with the Gmail account. Okay, right, so we'll just see if we have signed in. Okay, so I see the Suvarna, she has signed in, so we have signed in with Gmail account. So that's the first thing. Okay, right, so now we finished two steps. Installation we created a new account for TickTick, right? So now the third step is to do the settings. Okay, let's go to the settings, click on the settings here, go to the sound and notification. Okay, so you can pick the ringtone, whichever ringtone will keep the same as of now. Okay, so we want the always pop up to come up whenever there's a reminder which has been kept. Annoying alert, unless I complete the task or do the task, it keeps giving the alert. So I'll click this on, grant the access. Okay, it has to access some more things. Okay, stick on status bar. Yes, I want it to be on the status bar whenever there is a new task which is alert is there. So even though when the system goes for dose, it still gives you the alert. Yes, okay. Right, so that's it mainly. These all things will not vibration if enabled, app will vibrate when completing task, drag. Okay, we just keep it as we require that, like, you know, it looks nice, right? So this is the main settings which we are gonna look into, but one of the main thing which we'll be now looking into is how to optimize, right? So sometimes you do all these things still when the mobile is in the sleeping mode, you will not get the reminder. So what you have to do is, if the reminding is not working because you have not optimized the battery, okay, you should not optimize, you have to ignore optimization, for which I think you can just click here, you press ignore optimization, so automatically it goes to the battery optimization location. Let's see where it comes. Not optimized, so let's search for TickTick. Where's TickTick here? Oh, all apps, let's go for all apps. A, B, C, D, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T. Right, we have TickTick. So we don't want to optimize. Okay, if you optimize, the battery life of the phone will be better. So it is gonna make it sleep whenever, it will not operate whenever the battery is low. But we don't want to optimize so that it works in all circumstances. Okay. Mm-hmm. So now we'll press done. Okay, once it is done, so now it is will work in all circumstances, right? Okay, so we have TickTick here, right? So let's go to the inbox, right? So now the next step is is to run it in background. Okay, I want this app to run in the background and not that close when you close all the apps. for which now example you have to hold, come to the background of all the apps. These are all the apps running in the background, right? So normally what you do is, if you don't want this app to perform, you're gonna just press X and everything goes off. So we don't want that tick tick to happen like that. So just click this, okay, and press the lock. So now it is locked. Okay, so now press X button here, everything goes off except for tick tick. It always stays in the background and keeps on working for you. Okay, so now it will not go off, it's always there. Okay, so in that way your app is still running in the background. Okay, so now again go back to tick tick, right? So now we'll understand how to use it for our personal use. For example, tomorrow you want to buy a book. Okay, we already put a buy a book. Tomorrow you want to call Prashant, okay, and you may forget. So what I'll do is here, click call Prashant, okay, and I'll take the calendar tomorrow, or I can put on 30th, timings as afternoon 1:20 p.m. okay, and press okay, and just press it's in the inbox, so press next. So it goes to here, so you'll get it after 30 days. Okay, if you go to the calendar view, you'll get to know today what's your task. We have this, and on 26th or 27th what are the tasks, it's available here. So that's it. So every day you'll get to know what are the tasks. So if you go here and press today, so I don't have any tasks today. Okay, so if you go to the inbox, you'll have all the tasks which are aligned for next week or 1 month or after 1 year also. You can keep task. Okay, for example, now if you have a friend's birthday, for example, sister's birthday, and you come here, it's on 29th November. Okay, press it at night 11:30 p.m. okay, and more you press, okay, you repeat. Okay, yearly on 29th of November, you want every year at night 11:30 p.m. you'll get a reminder like that. You have either daily if you want to get up early morning, get something, or you want to every day you want to do something written active daily, or every week from Monday to Friday you can keep, or weekly, monthly fifth Friday, yearly, or you can do custom as per whatever you want. So that's how you can keep all the your reminders for yourself. Okay, and that's how it can happen, and endlessly. So that's also there. Okay, that's it. Okay, so you'll get to know. So now every year this one I'm just gonna cancel these two things because we'll not keep. Okay, sister's birthday, I'm gonna click here. Okay, just see, you can see here these two has the timer setting, but this one doesn't has the timer, so it will not give you a notification. So these two will give you a notification when the time comes. So let's do one thing, sister's birthday. So now we completed, task is complete. Call Prashant, completed. So once you finish, you just put complete. Okay, now buy book instead of tomorrow, I'm gonna keep it now. Now the time is 7:08, right? So now the time is 7:08. So let me keep a timing at 7:09. Oh, it's already 9:10. Okay, PM. Okay. And I'll click OK and go back. And we'll just go back and switch off. Close this one. Okay. We'll just wait and see what happens in a minute. Okay, so you got a reminder now. Okay, so it will not stop until, because you have done it as an annoying alert, it's coming again and again. So you have buy a book. Okay, so it's gonna pop up like this, buy a book. So and either you complete the task, it will go off. Okay, or you dismiss, it will not come again. Or you have to snooze, I cannot buy a book now, I'm traveling, I need some more time, I'll put it for 1 hour. It's postponed to 1 hour. Okay, so that's it. That's how the part one of Tick Tick for you to work for yourself. Thank you.